harder.
Thank you.
Potions you've brewed.
Nice to see you, my young friend. I need.
Samantha, is everything all right?
No, no, it's not. It's my brother William, the one I told you about after charms class. He's been cursed. He ignored my warning and now he's lying in St. Mungo's looking completely pathetic. He simply never listens.
I'm sorry, how exactly has he been cursed?
Oh, you won't believe it. Truly, but his feet were turned into purple beets. You can imagine his distress. And mine. I won't even go into the attention he was getting from our garden rabbits before he admitted himself to hospital.
I'm so sorry. That sounds like a trying situation.
I'm glad you understand. Everyone else just laughs at me as if it's a joke. No compassion at all.
Well, it is an unusual situation. How did your brother end up like this?
It's entirely his own fault. I told him about some research I'd done recently on our ancestor Marmaduke Dale. In particular, my discovery that Marmaduke's tomb was cursed. My brother's always making fun of my discoveries. This time, he laughed in my face. Told me I'd misinterpreted my findings. As if that were possible. And to prove his point, he went right up to the entrance of the tomb and poof! His feet transfigured into beets.
How awful. I can see why you're upset. He definitely needs some help.
Exactly. He may be a cape flapper, but he's still my brother. And no one deserves such a fate to last forever, especially as the result of a single brainless mistake. Now I worry that if the curse isn't reversed, it could become permanent.
Can't the curse be broken?
Possibly. The curse stems from a crest that was stolen from Marmaduke. If the crest were returned to its rightful place upon his sarcophagus, then I believe that William's feet may be restored. You battled trolls when they attacked Hogsmeade, escaped a dragon, and I could tell by your work and charms that you're a skilled spellcaster. Returning a crest to a sarcophagus should be almost effortless for you. So, will you help us?
How do you know it's safe? I don't want my feet to turn into beets as well.
Oh, but the curse only applies to Marmaduke's descendants, as my brother so aptly demonstrated. That's why I need your help. You're unrelated to my family, so the curse wouldn't affect you.
Why was Marmaduke's tomb cursed?
The curse is the result of an intense sibling rivalry between Granham Dale and his younger brother Marmaduke. Marmaduke was a famed herbologist, and Granham resented the attention that he received.
Sibling rivalry? Sounds as if it might run in the family.
But I would never intentionally curse my brother, not like Granham did. When their mother died, Marmaduke was given the prized family crest. Granham felt that as the eldest child, he should have been given it. Years later, when Marmaduke died, Granham stole it and cursed the tomb so that none in the Dale family could ever pay their respects.
Why is your ancestor so well known?
He discovered the properties of several magical herbs and plants. He also uncovered numerous types of flora. The wizarding world owes him a great debt. His work not only impacted the discipline of herbology, but also potion making.
I can take the crest to Marmaduke's sarcophagus for you.
Oh, thank you! Thank you so much! You'll simply go into the tomb where Marmaduke was laid to rest and place the crest on top of his sarcophagus. According to my research, the tomb's been abandoned for centuries, so it should be a fairly simple task. You'll find it just east of the hamlet of Brocburrow. Thank you for your help. My family is indebted to you.
To find the tomb near Brocburrow and place Samantha's family crest on a sarcophagus there.
Let's go! Come on, Highwing! Revelio. Faster, Highwing! Highwing, go! Master Highwing! Revelio.
I know a Merlin trial when I see one.
Revelio. Lumos. Revelio. Lumos.
These Merlin trials won't get the best of me.
Revelio. Revelio.
This could prove dangerous if I'm not careful.
Accio! Incendio!
A castle. Must have been quite stately in its time.
Accio! Incendio! Kringo! Accio! Incendio! Kringo! Revelio. Revelio. Incendio.
Incendio! Revelio! Revelio. Incendio. Revelio. Incendio! Accio! Wingardium Leviosa! Accio! Wingardium Leviosa! Leviosa. Revelio. Glacis. Revelio. Revelio. Incendio. Revelio. Accio. Wingardium Leviosa. Leviosa. Incendio. Revelio. Too hard. Revelio. Revelio. Accio. Incendio. I know what that means. Merlin trial. Confringer! Revelio. Confringo. That's that. Settled. Revelio.
Bombarda!
Revelio. Incendio. Revelio. 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 Everything's all right now. Revelio. Incendio. Accio. Incendio.
Confringo. Confringo.
should warn you, I won't make the same mistakes my colleagues have made.
Incendio. Accio. Incendio. Good finger. Accio! Incendio! Confringo!
It's exhausting! Standing here all day...
Accio! Incendio! Confringo!
I was a proud man that day, and there's more of those days...
Incendio. Revelio. Incendio. Now here's a sap. Accio. Legs is simp. Incendio. Revelio. Revelio. Glad I was never locked up here. Accio! Depulsor! Descendo! Flipendo! Revelio.
Revelio.
Here's one of those tables Professor Shaw mentioned. Likely this astronomy table will be best used when it's dark.
Revelio.
I'd be terribly grateful if you could help me and my friend with a time-sensitive delivery.
You sound as if you could use some help.
Oh yes, I could. Eddie Thistlewood's the name. A dear friend of mine in Feldcroft is at his wit's end due to the relentless attacks on his hamlet by Ranrock and his loyalists. I sent 2 crates of Chinese chomping cabbages to help, but they've gone missing.
Good idea. Those cabbages are nothing to be trifled with.
My thoughts precisely. You see, I know plants, and I believe the goblins will be so irritated by the onslaught of ferocious vegetation, they'll simply leave Feldcroft alone. I wonder if you might track the 2 crates down and deliver their contents to my friend, Bernard Ndiaye. I simply can't leave my shop at present.
Could you not grow or buy more Chinese chomping cabbages?
I suppose I could, but that would take time. Time we do not have, what with Ranrock's thugs posing new threats every day. Besides, it's the principle of the matter. I grew those cabbages, and they are extraordinary.
Why would the goblins target Feldcroft?
My friend Bernard says they've been seen in the area for a while. He seems to think they're looking for something, but lately they've become more aggressive.
Any idea where I might find the crates?
Yes. From what I hear, one was spotted south of Feldcroft. The other, so I hear, is south of Brocburrow near the river.
Very well, sir. I shall keep an eye out for 2 crates of Chinese chomping cabbages.
Oh, thank you. I shall let Bernard know he might be receiving those cabbages after all.
I should be going now. Thank you.
I'm convinced that Feldcroft will be much safer with Chinese chomping cabbages defending them.
Sounds like Feldcroft's in trouble. Perhaps I should try to help. Mr. Thistlewood, what was it you needed my help with? Crates of cabbages?
I wonder if you might track the two crates down and deliver their contents to my friend Bernard Ndiaye. I simply can't leave my shop at present.
Very well, sir. I shall keep an eye out for two crates of Chinese chomping cabbages.
Oh, thank you. I shall let Bernard know he might be receiving those cabbages after all.
What do you have for sale?
Now, how can I help? I'll be able to put that to good use. Thank you. I hope to see you again soon.
Revelio. Not sure how I'd fare in a little place like this. Alohomora. Revelio. Accio. Guardia Leviosa. Revelio. Mind now, Demi guys. Alohomora. Revelio. Accio. Guardian Leviosa. Revelio. Revelio.
Welcome, welcome. Do have a look around.
Revelio.
Oh, here's a pleasant surprise.
Revelio.
Ah, Brocburrow. Always a lovely place to visit. Give my best to I...
Be strong, Alexandra.
Revelio.
Looks rather dark in there. Never stopped me before.
Revelio.
Well, my feet didn't turn into beets. That's a good start.
Revelio.
Should have known a herbologist would use Devil's Snare.
Lumos.
A troll? You can't be serious.
Revelio.
Sarcophagus. This must be Marmaduke.
Revelio.
That should reverse the curse. Hopefully.
Revelio.
Well, Marmaduke certainly left behind more than plants.
Revelio. Capulso. Revelio. Revelio. Lumos. Incendio. Revelio.
Samantha will be glad to hear that the crest has been returned. I certainly hope it reverses the curse. Revelio. 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 The crate of Chinese chomping cabbages is somewhere in this camp.
If a beast can't outsmart me...
Anyone looking for troubles found it in me.
Revelio.
Brocburrow ain't good for much. Not unless you fancy getting squashed by a troll.
Now where did I set my trap?
You should never have carried it.
Mother used to always say, a clear head makes way for a clear path.
I haven't a clue why there's such a fuss over poaching. There's enough beast flesh for everyone.
Revelio.
There's
I have a few favourite hunting spots.
Revelio.
Best place Revelio. For beasts is the Forbidden Forest.
Where others see darkness,
Revelio. That's one crate in hand. I only need one more. That's one crate in hand. I only need one more. That's one crate in hand. I only need one more.
Revelio. Revelio.
Up for a bit of dying, are we?
I can see why Feldcroft needs help. Ranrock's loyalists are hiding out near Feldcroft. They must have the other crate of Chinese chomping cabbages. Petrificus totalis.
Who's that? One less human to worry about.
Revelio.
That's all the crates of Chinese chomping cabbages. I'd better go and see Mr. Thistlewood's friend in Feldcroft.
Revelio.
Hello there. Do you have the special delivery from my dear friend, Eddie?
Hello, Mr. NDI. Eddie Thistlewood sent me.
Yes, he told me to expect you. Do you have the Chinese chomping cabbages?
I have them right here.
Marvelous. This will go a long way towards protecting the hamlet from Ranrock's loyalists. The same foul curs who, I'm willing to guess, intercepted them in the first place, along with Rookwood's lot. Feldcroft owes a debt of gratitude to you and Eddie. Thank you for your help.
Do you have any idea why the goblins are attacking Feldcroft?
No clue. I used to think it was because of its strategic location, but now it's as if they were looking for something. I will admit, however, that I don't know what they could possibly be looking for.
How do you and Eddie know each other?
We met at Hogwarts. Been friends and business associates ever since. I wasn't surprised to get his owl about his Chinese chomping cabbage scheme. He was always one to go out of his way to help another.
What do you have for sale?
At last, some reinforcements. Hopefully this is enough to thwart the goblins. Stop by any time.
Off on another adventure, are we?
Ugh.
I'm happy to tell you that I returned the crest to Marmaduke's sarcophagus just as you asked.
I thought as much. I received word from St. Mungo's that my brother's feet are back to normal. No more beats. Oh, I cannot thank you enough. It wasn't too much trouble, I hope.
Just a measly old troll. Nothing significant.
A troll? Oh dear, I'm so sorry. That's awful. No one has been in that tomb for centuries. But I can't say I'm surprised. Marmaduke seems to have been full of surprises.
Indeed he was.
Well, I suppose I should be going. I'm anxious to see my brother, who must be elated to have his feet back.
Of course. I certainly would be.
William and I are forever in your debt. Thank you again for what you did.
Revelio.